ready to roll today. Going to do a bit of a Fuji circuit. Everything's great except for quick weather check. Yeah, it's been raining all night. And anyway, might clear up during the day. Anyway, can't do the quick getaway. I've got to go first to a gas station before I get on the highway. I always do that. I always tell myself that I should get gas at least a couple of days before or the day before, you know, when I'm just sitting around doing nothing. But no, never remember to do that. So here we are, stuck in traffic light purgatory here. There's nobody around. It's not even 7 o'clock here in the morning. What is going on with these traffic lights? I'm going to get back on track now. We have to do a small diversion back down to the road we're supposed to be on. We're in Akasaka, Nogizaka right now. And past Sony Music, actually. Into this tunnel in, we're in a tunnel here in underneath the Aoyama cemetery right now. That is 7 a.m. It's 7:20 and it's backed up already a few kilometers. Now this is a disturbing viewpoint. I'm already calculating alternatives, but I don't know if there are any new ones, because if I take this Tommy, the jump back up to the number 4 is just too big. Okay, we're gonna skip Ibina. We haven't been on the road long enough to warrant a break. Some more nice curves. This is the double parallel, the parallel section of the Tomei Expressway as it sort of starts this entrance in through the foothills. The road splits into two halves. They couldn't get a wide enough tunnel, I guess. But oh, look at that over there. That is the Big Red Bridge. I always call that the Big Red Bridge, and we know where we're talking about. I mean, first of the tunnels. Making good progress now. We're only 16 kilometers on our Gotemba exit. Oh, it's picturesque. I wish I could stop and find some good photography vantage points. Not so easy to do when you're on the back of a motorbike on an expressway. Is hoping for some quieter roads when we get on that 152, is it 469? There's some roads that I've earmarked as ones to put and try around the bottom of Mount Fuji. Hopefully there'll be some spots to pull off and do a little bit more probably there. Alright, we're in a long tunnel here. Ah, I can see your light at the end of the tunnel. This is a nice bridge going, oh, it's another Big Red Bridge, but a different Big Red Bridge. Now we're in the foothills. Sir, we have a sudden, unexpected curve here with an R equals 400. I like the very specific definitions of curves here. R equals 300. No, we have to. R equals 300 is one where you have to just start to take a little bit more attention. 400, no problem at all. 300, yeah. A bit of a look what you're doing. Ah, nice STI there. Oh, look at this classic Japan over here.
hope this is just the outskirts of Gotemba that I'm dealing with here. But as you can see, this is not anyone's definition of scenery. Oh, there's a nice old house there. That's about all. Pretty sleepy place at 9 o'clock on a Saturday morning. Not too much going on. I guess some people are passing through, leaving. What's happening here? Mr. Panasonic. Big old speakers there, I think. Junk pile. Well, at least I know you can get gas down here every 50 meters or so. Skirts of Mount Fuji, I guess you'd say. I think there's a lot of military land in there that says keep out. There are some US and Japanese Defense Force bases around here. But yeah, not a lot of exciting driving yet. Narrow road, not a passing road, the yellow line. Runoffs down into the valley. It's an interesting kind of place though, isn't it? It's like rolling folded hills over. Very grassy. No trees around here. Unlike anything I've seen in Japan. Okay, so there's some gradual lifting of the clouds. Very gradual. We're going to need some serious sun to come and burn this off in the next couple hours if I'm to see anything at all. I believe I should be seeing some postcard views of Mount Fuji right in front of us, but there's nothing. Well, no, I don't have nothing. If I wanted to get some snacks, I could have that over there. There's a convenience store. Alright, so it's raining now. Rapidly ascending this 180, road 180, route 180, in between patches of fog, the Serpentine Road. Oh, I missed that sign, what did that say? Crossing on 9% ascent, that's nice. A lot of bikers going the other way, that's nice. Mountain roads in Japan. And if you pick them at the right time, like this, it doesn't have to be busy, crazy, you know. It's the time of the year, it's before the leaf peeping season, you know, it's not the midsummer where the whole country's on Golden Week or Silver Week or Obon or any of those other times. You know, we're kind of in between vacations. I came out early from Tokyo, so, and I've got essentially this whole road to myself. It's unbelievable. You know, I'm only 150 kilometers from Tokyo. Oh, that's what they mean, a parking area? Oh, that's a nice... Was that that Ducati Scrambler? I think it was. Welcome to Fujinomiya. Have a nice day.
You can see in the mirror now that I'm a flash of yellow, which means I've got my yellow safety suit on. It's pretty amazing, this thing. Pretty amazing. And it's always a pity to carry it around in the back of the bike and not use it, especially when it is actually now raining. So had to make the decision to pull over, faff around until I can get this thing on, and then have to get everything else back on. Like, the gloves are tight and because they're wet and sticky. This one seems to be broken. Oh well, I'll just stop on the way home and buy some new gloves. Hasn't turned out quite the way that expected or hoped. But at least now I am dry. This is the Gotemba Trail. This goes up to the fifth station on Fuji. So we can start climbing from here. You know, this is one of the places you can come to start your climb of Fuji. I guess this is a tourist, this is where the tourist buses or tourist trips for Fuji will come. And I'm just interested to see what's up here. Pretty steep road. Ah, there's a bus for sure. Okay, what does it say here? There's a parking area. Bus parking. Okay, where was it? Looking at like a lava field. Interesting. I have to go for a little wander over there. I'm not sure what anyone's actually hoping to do here today. So you can't see anything. We're on the sides of Mount Fuji for sure. Maybe we'll a little bit further, see if we can go up. I'll unplug and see what I can see. I guess that's okay, it's just hot water coming out. Okay, interesting. Very black soil. Are we supposed to walk on it? Can you do it? I'll start my climb of Mount Fuji. Well, not really. I'm just going to go to here. But in theory, if I just kept going this way, I would soon be at the top. Yeah, that's definitely volcanic. Oh, I could clean up a little bit, couldn't I? Could use a bit of a scrub, couldn't it? Not very good for the video. Guys running up Mount Fuji, probably. With legs like that, probably done it before. Yeah, so it's, as expected, it's pretty abandoned because we won't be seeing too much up here today. But I'm going to have a quick look around because I probably won't be coming back here too soon. Maybe there's some snacks to be had. I still haven't had breakfast yet. Anyway, it says welcome to the fifth station and have a nice day. No, it doesn't say that at all. It says we should have taken our keys with us. That's what it says.
And
okay. Gotemba Trail, new fifth station, Shizuoka, Gotemba City. That is the climbing station. That is the Deguchi. Do we have to drive that way? Wow. It's mega slippery that way. What's all this? Commemorations. Parking lot. Gotemba Trail. Follow the Gotemba Trail. Gotemba. Warning, road blocked. All climbing tracks are closed. All right. So from the 10th of September to the summit, it's shut. But in theory, once you've gone past here, we're on the trail. We're on the trail to Fuji, so you can do this on your own. But they take no responsibility. Ah, this doesn't seem so bad, does it? I can say that I've climbed on Mount Fuji, and we're all done. So now we buy the souvenir, we buy the t-shirt. Dum da dum da dum da dum. Oh, forgot the selfies. Come on, what am I doing? Let's start again. Self camera. They seem to shrink as well as get sticky and all around ugliness. As the second visitor to Mount Fuji today, me being a first, we're only at the fifth station here, so a little ways to go. We're only less than halfway up Mount Fuji. 1,440 meters, and it's a pretty decent height though. Okay, so we're going to go across this Deguchi. The return road down here. Alright. Hey. We're not quite there yet.
But yeah, it's a drier down here. It's a little bit, But it's not been a, it has not been a particularly scenic trip. I mean, the road was nice. Some of the roads were nice. Probably got some, you know, money's worth out of that. But it is, when there's really nothing but fog, time to cut the losses and head home, get warm, get dry, and live to fight another day. Everything is so wet. Gloves are filthy and wet. They feel really, really nasty inside here at the moment. The inside of my helmet is, my face guard is wet. My glasses are wet on both sides. Look, I'm going to get back on the expressway around about here very soon. Very soon? Can't quite see over there. Oh, there's a sign. Tokyo, gate number 2. Okay. Gate number 2. That's what we want. And then, hopefully there'll be a rest area, the one that I stopped at up the way, maybe the same one. As we head back to Tokyo, it's probably an hour and a half from here. That's not a bad run. There we go. That truck could just that's pretty lazy stuff there. I go through the ETC here. That dude was ready for it, he was gunning. Alright, this is the Tomei Expressway, and in 1 kilometer, as predicted, Ashigahara. Look at this place. Bikes can go straight on. Bikes seem to be up the end there. Oh, no one really here. We'll take the first available slot here. Oh, there's really not much space, so that's enough. Okay. Let us have lunch. Hi, arigatou gozaimashita. That will be $15 or so. Hi, arigatou gozaimashita. So out of the 2,000, I will get 934. Domo arigato. Hi. Back in on the Tomei Expressway. Oh, Tomei boy. Oh, it's got that feeling of a full tank of gas. Very satisfying. cool looking bridge . This road is always marvellous. I've mentioned this a couple of times. Tome Road. This is Shintome, the new Tome Road is one of the favourite roads of mine. And this little part, you know, between here and when we get back out on the flat, you know, there's these curves, there's these down-sloping curves coming up on the down road. It's pretty cool. And because they build these roads essentially on stilts, you know, it's on the side of the mountain, but, you know, at a very artificial support underneath, and then it goes straight through the mountains. They can keep the road at an extremely predictable and appropriate grade. There's no real sudden changes in pitch. Let's not make that one of those days.